Just as long as I can remember, every 4 years about November, folks who wouldn't talk to me on the street are coming in my house and wiping their feet, kissing my wife, kissing my babies. Well, I guess they'd even kiss my old mule if she hadn't voted for Roosevelt.
Elections roll around every few years to help us sort things out.
I'd like to have your vote come election day. Now you don't need to know where I stand. Just vote for me as many times as you can.
There is not one challenge that America faces that we can't overcome with the innovation and energy and passion which has always been at the heart of
health
America.
Health costs are scheduled to exceed $4 trillion.
It's not acceptable. Our borders are broken. They must be repaired. It's a national security issue.
We need to strengthen the infrastructure.
We better reflect what the American people want. We are in a much better position to keep America safe.
We can't tackle the big problems that demand solutions.
But what if the countryside was much more of the solution than candidates even knew? What if the problems everyone had could be made better by bringing rural into the conversation?
It ain't complicated, folks. It just takes some courage.
The reality is that rural matters.
Elections, including presidential elections, get decided in rural areas.
Is there anywhere in America which has a sharper and more decided impact than rural communities and changes in the climate?
Well, I can't say I'm real excited, but I'm going to vote.
How do you get in the communities and actually change mindsets? And I think that's our challenge.
We're not afraid of fights. You know, we actually kind of like them.
We don't have confidence that government is going to make a difference in our lives.
Everybody ought to have to live in a FEMA trailer and lean over a toilet and brush their teeth. Nah.
I think right now what we're seeing is really a perfect storm. There is deep dissatisfaction with the war in Iraq. There is lingering and ongoing concern about the economy, even though the candidates aren't really talking about it.
The government is not here to help the people.
Rural voters are expressing an unhappiness.
As bad as things get, there's always good days.
With Chuck Grassley, I have a glass of ethanol every morning just after breakfast.
As a farmer, if the economics are not in it, it's not sustainable.
We could have the rural simple life, but we could also have access to the world.
What I do know is that we need a candidate and an agenda that's competitive in rural America.
So how can we create jobs and economic opportunity that protects and maintains a healthy environment?
I think there's a lot more that we could do to create a greater sense of belonging.
It's going to be tough, but I think it is achievable.